let me know if you're here. One in chat if you're here. Get them. We will go on until the end.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of Magmatic
Adventures. Let's watch some videos. This one's modded.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another episode.
All right, now let's get this shaped right. What's going on here?
So today I want to take a look at some things It had a request in the comments that we should take a look back at the getting started and try and complete this. I agree, we should probably complete as much of this as we can. So we have two unclaimed rewards here for these different harvest level quests. Firewood Broadaxe Head, I don't really care about. Sponge Broadaxe Head, I don't really care about. Evil Infused Broadaxe Head, I don't really care about. However, the Evil Infused we could melt down and do something else with. We could turn it back in ingots. We'll, those are more useful than any of these other two. I think we're going to just go ahead and claim that. I don't think we're actually going to use that as a part. The Manulin one, we had Prudentium Excavator or Emerald Excavator. Well, I don't know about Prudentium, but I know Emerald we can at least melt down and get gems out of if we wanted to. So I'm going to take that one. The other one, yeah, I don't really think we're going to get much use out of. So anyway, the next one in our list of things to do here was the Ozgloglaz Sharpening Kit. So another reason that I wanted to work on this quest, or I guess on this page, people had mentioned in the comments, like, during the very first episode, we received a reward for that. Yeah, I completely forgot about this. That feels like forever ago to me. Yeah, so we got a reward for this one. So we already had these items. We didn't have to get into mechanism and do all of that, although we will get into mechanism, but we don't have to do that to complete this quest, right? So we can go ahead and melt those down. Let's get back into here real quick. And that wants us just to have the sharpening kit for the next mining level. Now it says that it has a mining level of whatever that is, the Ozgloglaz, but I don't know like what that means. Like what requires this particular mining level, I don't know. It's just like, it's having us upgrade our mining level over and over again for some reason, but yeah, I don't really know what it is that we need that requires that. I don't think you can search GEI, for instance. So if we search for, I don't know, gold ore, it doesn't say like on this tooltip here what the mining level is. It only says it if you're looking at the block in the world. So yeah, I'm not really sure what requires these different mining levels, to be completely honest. So we gotta wait for that to melt down, then we can pour that out into the sharpening kit cast, and then upgrade, or I guess complete this quest. So while we're waiting on that, there was this other quest line here, the scanning. It says there's a slight chance per chunk that super ore veins generate. There are six different kinds of super veins, which can be found at varying Y levels. Nuclear craft ores only spawn in super veins. This pack has a few different items that can help you find ores, the scanner being one of them. So I've used a scanner a little bit, I believe, in Sevtech. I believe this was the item that I used. And I have seen some super veins, although we haven't really seen it on camera together. When I was down in the branch mine mining, every time I mine an ore, I hold the vein mine button and mine all of the ore, right? Well, there's been times where I've done that, like I mine some redstone and I just get an inventory full of redstone. Then I see redstone trying to come at me through the walls because of our magnet. So I go and mine that, and then I open up another small little cavity, and then I see more redstone through the walls trying to come at me. Yeah, so anyway, there's like, I've seen a bunch of redstone, or at least two super redstone veins down below in the mine. So yeah, I do know that they exist, but I haven't seen any of these crazy ones that might require, well, at least the nuclear craft ones. So that'd be kind of interesting if we could scan for those. Let's take a look. It said that we had to make ourselves a scanner, and that does require energy. Do we have a way to charge this thing yet? I'm not sure. Can we even make this yet? Let's take a look. That is not expensive, to be completely honest. All right, so let's make this. We need iron bars, I believe, was the missing component here. So there's that, and there's that. Okay, so scanner, so that should be another quest complete. Nice. Let's upgrade the mining level of our pickaxe. I guess we could do that for our stone hammer, too. You know, if we melt down another one of those, we could upgrade the mining level, and that our hammer will be less annoying to mess with while we're down in the branch mine. So let's grab flint. We need two of those, one for each tool. And that upgrades us to the next mining level. Awesome, awesome. So yeah, we gotta wait for this to finish up here, and then we gotta figure out how we're gonna charge this scanner. I'm not exactly sure how we're going to do that right now. I know there are various different methods of charging, but I don't think we have any at the moment. Unless we can charge it in maybe one of these generators over here or the battery. Do we have an option of charging this here? Oh, okay. Well, there we go. All right. Well, let's wait for the other sharpening kit to melt down, and we'll be right back, guys. All right, guys. So I decided to take our emerald pickaxe head, axe head, shovel head. No, it's the excavator head. That's what it was. I decided to take that, melt it down, and turn it into a hammer head. Well, we made our hammer unbreakable previously, right? So we still have, like, not very great mining speed on it, 6.89. Yeah, the emerald one by default has 7. The evil infused I was looking at has 13, which would be better. However, like, reading up on what that material does, it says it brings misfortune to the wielder. So I was like, and probably not. And then the stone hammer head by default has a mining speed of 4, so we should gain 3, maybe? I don't know. Either way, it's going to be better than using the stone, and since it's unbreakable, it doesn't matter what the material is. We don't ever have to repair it again. So we're at a 6.89, and we put that, it brings up to 7.3. So not exactly 3 levels of speed increase, but yeah, on hammers, it's kind of weird. I also did, just now off camera, replace one of the plates on the hammer with copper and the other one with iron, which gave us a little bit more durability, some more mining speed, and of course, we get XP now as we mine, and blocks kind of get magnetized and brought to us as we mine. Which really isn't a huge issue since we have the magnet on us, but we might not always have a magnet. So anyway, I just figured we'd upgrade those parts and make it a little bit better. So yes, we have a pretty good hammer now. It has a high mining level, it has decent mining speed. As we gain more levels on it, we'll put more redstone, it'll get faster. I think it'll be better overall. So yeah, pretty happy with that at this point. So the scanner, let's take a look. If I right click, no scanning module installed. Okay, so you have to shift right click, and then you get these options here. Oops, looks like it's turning nighttime again. This is from Scannable? Scannable, yes, okay. So Scannable, right. So blink scanner, range, animals, monsters, common ores, rare ores, block, structures, fluids, entities. Aha. So you can scan for a whole bunch of different things using that, but you have to make all of the upgrades in order to do that. Yep. Okay, so let's take a look at some of these different things here. So if we want to find, I guess, rare ores that cost 1,000 energy, so we need a blink scanner module. So that is some kind of green dye, clay, redstone, gold nugget. Okay, so we don't have green. Do we have any cactus? We do. Go ahead and put that in here. And there's our green dye. Right. And there's a blink scanner module. And then we'll turn that to the rare ore one. Wait, we don't have any diamond? Oh, they're all in block form. Okay. There we go. So there is the rare ore. So if I put this in here and I right click, okay, so now it's doing something. Okay, so we can see big blocks of different stuff. So whatever that is, that's probably one of those huge ore veins. So that said it costs 1,000. Yeah, it definitely costs 1,000 energy. Let's do this again, see what else we can see around here. Okay, and they are different colors. Interesting. I'm very curious what this is right in front of us. Let's check this out. Let's mine towards it. I didn't expect to see any rare ores like this high to the surface. Oh, okay. So apparently apatite is considered a rare ore, huh? Okay, okay. Well, let's vein mine it since we're here. Ooh, that was a lot, wasn't it? Fairly substantial amount. We got some iron here and a little bit of Sirtis. Okay, that's awesome. Yeah, the elemental effect on the hammer, it said if you are mining so the emerald hammer head there says elemental on it. It says if you're mining gravity blocks with it, it mines all of them, like above and below, so I guess you don't get them falling on your head or whatever. I haven't given that a try yet. I think that might be interesting for when I actually am mining a bit. But yeah, let's see if we can find anything else here. What else do we got? Different color ores. Not seeing any, like, huge ore veins. I don't know what these, if those are, like, gold or what. Let's get down lower here. Let's get down to, like, diamond level and do this. See if we got anything nearby. Okay. See different ores around us. I'm not seeing any huge ore veins, though. But apparently there's something right here. Is that lead? No, that's diamond. Okay, that's... Well, I am kind of curious. It looked like that was a really huge ore vein. Maybe it's just showing, like, the regular bounding box or whatever around these diamond ores. Yeah, this doesn't look big, does it? Looks just like a standard diamond ore vein. All right, so not a big deal. Let's keep going. See if we can find anything that's, like, really big. That right there looks a little bit larger than normal, doesn't it? Maybe not. Maybe that's just like... What do we got here? Find out what ore it is. Okay, so it's gold. Need some redstone. Alright. Well, I would like to see what we can find. If we can find like a huge ore vein or something. Maybe we need the common ores in order to do that. I'm not sure. We do have like a very, very long tunnel here that I have mined out. So I'll tell you what, I'm going to go down here and scan a bit, see if I can find anything that's interesting, and then we'll be right back, guys. Okay, guys, so as I'm making my way down this really long tunnel, I was scanning, and right here it appears there is something rather big. I have no idea what this is. There's like a lot of little things inside of it, but let's kind of poke over this way and see what we can come up with. All right, so we got some amber ore. That's not probably what that ore thing is, but yeah, I mean, I'm kind of curious what that is. Thorium ore, boron ore. Okay, so that seems like the nuclear craft stuff. Oh, okay. That's manulin, cobalt, manulin. Aha, so the nuclear craft ores, they did say that it spawns in like huge ore veins or whatever. So it must be they just put random ones in there and you have to just find them all, huh? Okay, it's interesting. But can we vein mine these? Okay, so we got magnesium as well. Oh, right. So this is going to be quite interesting to get all these nuclear craft ores. I'm not sure, like, how much nuclear craft stuff we have to do right now. Actually, let's test out the hammer and see how this thing works. That's not bad. I like it. Okay, yeah, I'm not sure like how much nuclear craft stuff we have to do and like how soon we have to do it. But yeah, looks like there is a heck of a lot of ore here. And good luck trying to find this without that scannable thing, right? So anyway, let me go ahead and clean this out, grab all these ores, see if we can find another huge ore vein, and we'll be back, guys. Alright guys, to give you an idea of the size of that room, my goodness. Yeah, it ended up being not kind of confined to what it showed that those ores were. Like, they were pretty much all over the place. I'm not convinced that I got them all. There's another one right here. There's some boron. Did I just see something over here? There's a little bit of thorium. Anyway, so yeah, the ores were kind of spread all over the place. They had to mine kind of a big area to get them all. And we ended up getting almost 2 stacks of boron, about a stack and a half-ish of thorium, some magnesium, some lithium. But yeah, they were just kind of spread all over. You can't really just vein mine them since there's a little bit of ores here, a little bit there. So yeah, you kind of have to just mine out the entire area. Goodness. So yeah, we ended up with quite a bit of the nuclear craft ores, which is fine. So I guess what I'm going to do is I'll continue down the path here, see if we can find any other rare ores or whatever. Maybe there's something else that we don't know about. We know nuclear craft spawns in a big vein. I would like to find one of those huge redstone ones, but I don't know if we're going to be able to find it with the rare ores or we just have to do the regular ores. But anyway, I'm going to continue on until this thing runs out of power, and we'll be right back. All right, guys. So once again, down here in the mines, I am using the scanner. I have since made ourselves a common ores module, and then I put in two range upgrades. These both increase the energy cost by a little bit, but it's still cheaper than just doing the rare ores one every single time. So yeah, 500 for the common, 100 for each of the range modules. Let me take some of those out a little bit, and we can kind of see the difference. So if I scan here, there's like a big redstone area, it looks like, in this section. There's something else up above. But yeah, you can kind of see about what we were seeing before. So with these range modules in here, if we do this one more time, it like does a whole big area. It's really hard to see everything around. I don't know if there's a way to filter by specific ores. In fact, actually, I know there is. How do we do it? Fluid entities. Maybe it's the block. Maybe you can specify use on a block to configure the module. Yeah, so you can specify if you only want to find like diamond ores. I think it'll only highlight those if you use this particular thing. But anyway, I did want to see this redstone one. This seemed like it was a fairly large compared to the other ones around. It seems pretty big anyway. Let's see what happens if we mine this. What do we get? We get like 16 redstone. Is that it? I thought this was going to be one of those big redstone veins. Maybe I was mistaken. If we scan again, does it show any more redstone here? It still says there's redstone here. So I'm not convinced that we got it all, since it still kind of shows the vein active. And it is hard to see what we're doing while that box is still there. Well, I'm not seeing anything else here. I saw there's some iron, but I'm not seeing any more of the redstone. Let me grab the hammer, actually. See if we can do this a little bit more efficiently, a little bit faster. Okay, so there is some redstone right here. Let's try and get this. All right, so that was a decent amount of redstone. Okay, is this one of those big veins, maybe? It seemed like I had some redstone coming at me a little bit. Well, I don't know. We ended up with like 2.5 stacks of redstone. Not a whole crazy amount. Not what I was expecting. Yeah, I still want to find out what one of those super redstone veins looks like, because I have seen them before, but I want to see what they look like on the scanner. All right, for sure we got something here. I'm not sure what it is. It's not redstone, but this is a pretty big cube area. See if we can poke over into it, just kind of see what we got in this general spot. Okay, so that's gonna weigh. It wasn't just this basalt, was it? Am I gonna just mine into a whole lot of lava here? Oh boy. It says it's supposed to be rare minerals or whatever, right? So hopefully there is something here. I'm not sure what that white was though. Okay, so there's still some more redstone. Some lapis. So what was this supposed to be? I wonder. There's some malachite. Let's scan it again. Oh, you know what? I guess I didn't get to it just yet. That is such a big area. Okay, so it's still in front of me. So I see redstone here. Let's keep going. What is this? So there's a lot of silver and lead. Maybe that's what this is, a super silver and lead area. I don't know. Yeah, more silver, more lead. Okay, well, you know what? That appears to be what this is, actually, because I see a whole lot of that stuff around. Let's get rid of this. Okay, yeah, more lead over here. How much have we collected so far, I wonder? Oh yeah, look at that. Oh, no, that's not lead, that's tin. Tin, a whole lot of tin, 2 stacks of tin and some silver. Okay, that's pretty good, actually. There's still some more silver and lead around, though, but I don't think that's what that vein was. I think it had to have been that tin, yeah? That's a little bit more tin there. All right, so I was just checking the other end of our tunnel here. Our staircase is just right there. And at the end of this tunnel, I did see that there was what appears to be a huge redstone area here. So, yeah, I kind of dug into it till we found a little bit of redstone. How much redstone do we have in this thing? We have 356. So if I vein mine this, like, we're going to end up getting stupid amounts of redstone. They're just kind of, like, all over the place, guys. Yeah, you get it a whole lot, and it's up and down and everywhere, and yeah, you might not block, then you still see like redstone coming at you from like different various locations. It gets a little crazy, so it's probably best just to vein mine a whole lot of spots here and let it all come to you. So if we look in this one more time, yeah, we just got over 700 redstone there from that one ore, and there's probably still more behind these walls and stuff that we can't see. Like if I vein mine a little bit more, see, here's more redstone, guys. These things are just insane. So yeah, especially if you're mining and you're vein mining like that, just be aware that there's these huge ore veins and you're gonna like expose large amounts of resources, so just be prepared for that. All right, guys, so I put all the ores away that we just discovered here that we got done mining. So the scanning, when since we completed the quest, we get ourselves a loot chest, so we'll go ahead and claim that. So the loot chest is a Benevolent Goddess's Charm. I'm not actually sure what that does. We would have to look in the Lexica Batania to see. And it seems like a lot of these items from Batania require mana. Well, it goes right there, but I'm not sure what that actually does for us, if anything. I'm sure it does something. You know what, for now, I'm not gonna put it on. We'll just put this away. Since I don't think we have a Lexica Batania. No, we don't. Can we make one real quick? I wonder. Lexica Batania. Oh, yeah, yeah. See if we can make that real quick. Maybe we'll find out what that item is. So we need paper, a little bit of leather. What can we do here? So there's that. This. Okay. So we gotta go through the little intro thing, go back. All right, so we wanna find the index and we can type the search. So that was called a Benevolent Goddess's Charm. Is a defensive bauble that can, as the name implies, be worn in the charm slot. While worn, the cost of some mana, which we don't have, from the wearer's inventory. Any explosions that happen in the wearer's nearby vicinity will cease to damage any blocks in the world. Oh, that's kind of cool, I guess. And that's the recipe. It's not like super expensive. No explosion. All right. Well, not something we particularly need at the moment, so we'll put that away. We don't have mana to even use it if we wanted to. So harvest level 9 gives us 8 atomic alloy. Let's go ahead and claim that up, and we'll put those away. That'll help us out when we get into the mechanism section of our quest book. So for right now, the next thing that we can do is Enderium sharpening kit, but I don't think we can make Enderium yet. I'm pretty sure we have to get into either Ender IO or thermal expansion to do such things. So Enderium blend requires pulverized lead, platinum, and resonant pearl. And I don't think we can get the resonant pearl. Well, maybe we might be able to melt them down in the smeltery. There might be a way around that. It doesn't show that we can do that. Let's see. If we put some ender pearls, well, we don't have a whole lot, do we? Yeah, we wouldn't have enough. We need 4 of those for a bucket. So we can't even do that if it smelt in the smeltery. So let's not even bother. Let's see. Getting started. So yeah, rare ores. It says some ores are so rare that they don't even generate on Earth, the Nether, or the End. Explore the galaxy to find them. Among them are iridium, rutile, all cathrades, star metal, draconium, and dilithium. Okay, so that's going to give us 10 levels of experience. And we'll claim it. And we completed the quest, rare ores. So we're done with everything on the first page that we can do. We're going to have to upgrade our mining level as we progress with the pack. So we can't really complete anything else just yet. Let's go ahead and just grab these, what were those called? The controllers from XNet. We'll grab those, just claim that quest, because that's gonna bother me that it's unclaimed for so long. So yeah, we have a few other places to go here in the book. Let's see, metal press. We can't really do that, I don't think. Light engineering block. We need a heavy engineering block in order to make the metal press. That requires us to be in the mechanism. So yeah, we can't do that quite yet. So Thaumcraft, we might be able to do something at Thaumcraft. I don't know. Let's kind of get down to mechanism. I think that's what I said that I want to start with. So let's go ahead and kind of jump into this a little bit, see what we can do. It says, welcome to Mechanism. Mechanism is a tier 2 tech mod with tons of content. It offers some of the fastest machines, near infinite energy storage, insanely powerful generators, and a lot more. The recipes haven't been altered much. The energy usage of most machines is far higher than normally, though. This chapter leads to heavy machinery from immersive engineering as well as thermal expansion. Okay, so click the checkbox. We get ourselves a configurator, which is nice. And that opens up some of the basic things. So metallurgic infuser. The metallurgic infuser can infuse various materials with coal, redstone, diamond, obsidian, or biofuel. It produces the main crafting components used throughout mechanism. You're going to need tons of circuits and alloys, so it's a good idea to craft them in bulk or automate the production. That seems like a good idea. So a metallurgic infuser, let's take a look at that. In order to make one of these, oh boy, we need an external heater, which requires LV wire coils and all of this stuff. Ah, this is where all the fun expert mode crafting comes into play, huh? Okay. Steel casing does require 2 blocks of osmium and a reinforced blast brick. Wow. Steel mechanical components, which we can do in the engineer's workbench, and some more osmium. So for all of our trouble here, we do get 2 steel casing for this recipe, and that is the only recipe available. Yeah. Okay. Well, I'm going to go ahead and start crafting up all this stuff. We can do this. These are all things that we've done before. It's just going to take a minute then to do it. So let me get to it, and we'll be right back, guys. All right, guys. Well, I went to go make some steel casings here. Actually, I made the external heater, and I did a shift click to show what all we had ready to go, and I was preparing to make these steel casings, but apparently we already had some from before. We got them from a reward. I'm not exactly sure, but anyway, here's our metallurgic infuser. That should complete that first quest here. Yeah, so metallurgic infuser, let's go to the mechanism section, and we will take, how about the top loot chest? Let's claim that. All right, so we will pop this, and we get ourselves an insanium tinker table. I'm not sure what that does for us. What would insanium do that is that great, other than, I mean, we already have a tool for, wait, tinkering table from mystical agridition. Okay, I was thinking that was a tool forge. It's not. This is different. So insanium tinkering table. Oh right, so this is how you make the different armors and stuff, I think, from mystical agriditions. Yeah, that's definitely something that will be useful eventually when we get into mystical agriculture and that kind of stuff. For right now, not so much, but we'll just hold on to that for later. Okay, awesome. So now that we have the metallurgic infuser, let's set that down real quick and see what the power requirements are. Does it say on here if we are F? So it needs, or it uses 60 RF per tick by default. Now we can lower that down by putting in the upgrades here. It does support energy upgrades, and that does lower the amount of energy it requires. So I expect at the very start here, we're just gonna put in 8 energy upgrades into this machine, drop that RF requirement down, and just call it good. Maybe add in 1 to 2 of the other upgrades until we get into making a lot more RF per tick than what we currently are right now. So beyond that, we can get into the enrichment chamber and all these other things and these other crafting components. Yeah, the metallurgic infuser by default can make the basic control circuits and the enriched alloys, I think, fairly easily. But yeah, we're definitely...
your way, 'cause you walked off so fast yesterday. No, I don't think you're here to stay. No, I don't think you're here to stay. So tell me what you want, tell me how you want it, tell me all the reasons that you're running away. I don't think you're here to stay. No, I don't think you're here to stay. No, no, no.
I just wanna be with you. I just wanna be with you.
Hey everybody, welcome to another Redstone video. There has been some remarkable development yesterday in terms of double speed item sorters that don't require hopper minecarts. After I showed my video, Ground 15 had a groundbreaking idea which was later refined by Ether and Pella. So on the back of me you can see the newest double speed item sorter, and it's probably as compact as it gets. So Ground 15's truly astonishing idea was that the hopper with the filter items facing downwards is dead to the side, and this way we can get double transfer speed into this hopper. One hopper actively pushes them to the next hopper, and this one sucks it out from the hopper above. And this hopper with the item type that is supposed to be filtered is blocked by the redstone torch. So once we put in items here at the top, then we will transfer the items at double speed to this hopper, and here we do the same. This hopper tries to push them over into this hopper, and also the hopper below sucks them out. So we get items at double the speed into this chest. The redstone in the back is identical to a normal item filter system. We use signal strength 3 for the overflow protection. I build up an array for demonstration, different item filters, and the system in the back would actually kind of deserve its own video. this system in the back fixes an issue I've shown yesterday. So if you have the items at such a high speed going over the ice stream, then a lot of the hoppers would miss the items, since they have a cooldown if they transfer items. And this cooldown also affects items to be picked up. So if this cooldown starts, then the hopper also can't actively pick up items that flow above it. So this system here in the back that I built up deals with this issue by making batches of items which are sent at certain intervals. So as you can see, we dispense 18,000 items per hour now, and the hoppers are able to pick up all of them. That is for the purple dye. As you can see, we have the double sorting speed, and it's really no problem that we use the high speed ice system. Alright, just try to explain it a bit. So we make batches of items, we activate this trapdoor here every so often, then we have a second trapdoor, since if you would use different items, sometimes the items wouldn't stack together, but we still want to have them arrive basically at this trapdoor at the same time, so we basically align them. Maybe we'll just put in different item types on top so you can see it's better for what the second trapdoor is good for. Okay, now we got different items, as you can see. We need to align them again so they would all travel at the same time. The clue of the system is actually that the interval between the opening of this trapdoor varies. So I can demonstrate this by using the same interval all the time, just by setting this repeater to 4. If we do this, then every second time the hopper wouldn't pick up the batch of items. So it's getting picked up the first time, also the second time now, but the third time the items would go over this hopper, because the hopper is at a cooldown. So now it would pick up the items again, and the next batch would be missed again. And this is the problem with the item filter system. This would, by the way, also affect normal item filters, so normal speed item filters. We actually have this issue on the Cycroft server as well with the main storage. But I think with this knowledge and this system, I can probably even fix it. Alright, so now I want to demonstrate the fix for this issue. So here we have a T flip-flop system. So every second time we open the trapdoor at a different interval of less delay in between. Right, so you can see here we get the first batch of sugarcane, and now it also works with the next batch and the batch after that, and this is how you could fix this issue. The redstone here in the back isn't really optimized, but just made a working version regardless of the size. I might make a cleaner version at some point and also make a video about it, but if you're already interested in maybe this system, then you can find it in a world download. Then one more note. So you have a 1-byte tileable double speed item sorter. You might also want to put those items into a shulker box, so you need a double speed shulker box filler. And Pella already showed a version last weekend, but it had the older double speed item sorter, which was a bit more bulky. And at the moment he's working on a version that works with this item filter, which should be more compact in the end. So I also link Pella's channel in the video description, subscribe to him so you won't miss the system. Thanks a lot for watching, have a nice day, bye bye!
Hi guys, Gnemon here, and welcome to this video. Today what I initially planned to show you was a really practical and useful item elevator. Got carried away and revamped the entire sorting system in the process. I hope you don't mind. And I'm really, really pleased with the result. You know, the main issues people have with primary and secondary with a clock that powers in the beginning comes from. As you can see, the side of the system is perfectly cut off. So what I did, I thought I can just move the rail controls to the other side of the module and simply slap two of these modules together, leaving one block of gap in between. And that's how it turned out. So first we have our double ender chest module attached to the other one with mirrored control tower. And then I rotated the entire thing twice to have them all around and chain all of them together. So we have here one input chest and one output chest at the end. Although we can still put items in the middle of the chain as well by accessing these chests here in the corners. And this here system I was able to run at 100 TPS, so I could even replicate the entire thing 5 times no problem, and I'll fit between the absolute 20 TPS limit. An FPS wise client is also doing very good, so no problems with that as well. So at the end, let's hop onto the tutorial section which I updated with the modifications I made. As you can see, item
Alright guys, and that's going to be the conclusion of my live stream for now. I might come back later tonight. We'll see. Thank you for coming. Have a great day. Goodbye.